What if your job was to smash into walls of ice every single day? In pitch darkness, freezing storms, and temperatures so low they can freeze your breath midair. Far above the Arctic Circle, the sea isn't really a sea. It's a frozen battlefield of solid ice stretching for thousands of miles. And somewhere in that endless white, a giant steel ship is smashing through it, mile by mile, day and night. This is an icebreaker, a special kind of ship designed not to avoid ice, but to crush it, shatter it, and open up the world's last locked places. It's the only thing standing between remote Arctic towns and starvation. But behind the roar of giant engines and crashing ice, hundreds of people live on these ships for months at a time, far from civilization, daylight, or even land. But what's life really like on board? How do these steel monsters break the ice? And why do people choose to work in some of the harshest places on Earth? Find out on our channel, The Curious Corner. At first glance, an icebreaker looks like a normal ship. Maybe a beefed-up research or supply vessel. But under the surface, it's a different beast entirely. Icebreakers are built to do what no other ship can: punch through solid ice sheets that stretch for thousands of miles. Without them, huge parts of the world's oceans would be completely cut off every winter. The biggest icebreakers are operated by countries that rule the frozen north, like Russia, Finland, Canada, and the US. Some are state-owned, some support oil and gas companies, and a few are even used for adventure cruises to places like the North Pole. These ships aren't armed with saws or drills. They rely on brute force and clever design. Their bows are curved and heavily reinforced. Instead of slicing straight through the ice, an icebreaker rides up onto it. The ship's massive weight, often over 20,000 tons, crushes the ice from above. This unique design means an icebreaker doesn't glide like a normal ship. It smashes, climbs, and grinds forward, sometimes only a few meters at a time when the ice is thick enough to stop even the toughest steel. But how do the people inside survive this brutal environment? Let's step inside. From the inside, an icebreaker feels like a cross between a ship, a factory, and a tiny floating city. A large icebreaker can have a crew of anywhere from 50 to over 100 people: engineers, deckhands, navigators, cooks, scientists, even medics, as things can go so wrong so fast. Unlike luxury cruise ships, the cabins are small and functional, just enough space for a bunk, a desk, and a locker. Personal space is a rare luxury here. And the work? It never stops, not even in the dead of night, which in the Arctic winter can last for months. However, it isn't just about adventure or exploration. For thousands of people living in remote Arctic communities, an icebreaker can mean the difference between survival and disaster. In places far above the Arctic Circle, tiny villages in Alaska, remote outposts in northern Canada, or isolated towns in Russia's far north, winter seals off the world. No planes, no trucks, no roads, just miles and miles of unbroken ice. Without an icebreaker to cut a path, supply ships can't reach these communities with food, fuel, and medicine. In the harshest months, icebreakers lead entire convoys of cargo ships through frozen seas, carving safe routes so the ships behind them don't get trapped or crushed by shifting ice. One broken engine, one blocked passage, and the entire supply chain could fail. Everything from fresh vegetables to heating oil depends on that narrow channel of open water behind an icebreaker's wake. Without it, some Arctic settlements would simply run out of essentials, leaving families to survive on dwindling stocks until the ice thaws, sometimes months later. At the helm, officers navigate through shifting ice fields and unpredictable weather. They rely on satellite data, radar, and sheer experience, because one mistake can trap the ship in ice so thick, it might take days or weeks to break free. Down in the engine rooms, engineers maintain the ship's powerful engines. Some icebreakers run on diesel, others are nuclear powered, like Russia's giant fleet. These floating powerhouses can keep moving for years without refueling. Between shifts, the crew gathers in the mess hall. Meals are hearty. You burn a lot of calories in sub-zero conditions. There's a gym, maybe a sauna if it's a Russian or Finnish icebreaker, and a tiny recreation room with movies or board games. But no matter how cozy it gets inside, there's no escaping the isolation. The harsh weather creates a depressing environment for the crew. For weeks, sometimes months, there's no sun, no land, no fresh supplies. Crew members miss birthdays, holidays, and family milestones. They deal with storms so violent, the entire ship shudders and groans as it punches through ice thicker than a grown man is tall. Many icebreakers carry researchers who study the polar regions, climate change, ocean currents, rare wildlife. They drill deep into the ice, measure its thickness, and gather data that could help predict the future of our planet. Without icebreakers, this kind of research would be almost impossible. Sometimes helicopters land on the deck to bring in fresh supplies or to evacuate someone in an emergency. But in the Arctic, help is never close. If something goes wrong, the crew has to handle it themselves, from fires to medical emergencies, or even the malfunctions. So why do people choose this life? For some, it's adventure, the thrill of pushing into places few humans ever see. For others, it's the sense of purpose, keeping supply lines open for remote communities, guiding cargo ships through frozen passages, supporting research that could change the world. And yes, for many, it's the pay. Working months in harsh conditions, away from family, often comes with higher wages. However, there are perks you can't put a price on. Imagine standing on deck in the silence of the Arctic night, with the northern lights swirling above and the ice cracking below. For a moment, the whole world is just you, the sea and the sky. So next time you hear about an icebreaker smashing its way through the frozen ocean, remember, it's not just a ship, it's a lifeline, a research lab, and a test of human endurance. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe our channel, The Curious Corner, for more fascinating content.